frustrated with your smart switch installation because there's no neutral wire in the switch box? Today we're going to install and set up the Lutron Caseta wireless smart dimmer in a three-way switch application with the Wink Hub 2. And this video will also work for replacing a single switch, so stay tuned. Hi again, John Stone, the DIY smart home guy. I get a lot of questions about what to do with a smart switch installation when the switch box has no neutral or white wire. There can be many reasons why you don't have a neutral wire in your switch box, the most common being that you're in an older home and they just didn't use the same wiring practices that are found in the newer home construction. So today, we're going to use the Lutron Caseta wireless smart dimmer switch. It's important to note that this switch should only be used for dimmable lights. These include incandescent lights, dimmable LEDs, dimmable CFLs, or dimmable halogens. If you need a regular on-off switch, Lutron also makes a non-dimming on-off in-wall smart switch. There's also a link to this smart switch in the description below. If you've watched some of my other videos, you'll recognize this switch as the one I use to control my bar light. This switch will work standalone or as a three-way switch if you purchase the pack with the Pico remote and an additional Lutron wall plate bracket for the Pico. There are additional helpful videos and affiliate links for all products used in the video in the description below. So let's take a look at the switch. Inside the box, you'll find the in-wall dimmer, the Pico remote, three wire nuts, and a couple of mounting screws. The switch even comes with its own decorative wall plate, which is really nice. This is a very complete product in terms of what the DIY installer will need to get up and running. Since Lutron provides the Pico remote in this particular kit, you can have control over the switch without a hub.
But where is the fun in that?
So here are some facts about the Lutron Caseta line of switches. These are not Z-Wave or Zigbee devices. The Caseta line operates on the 434 MHz radio frequency and uses a protocol which they refer to as ClearConnect. This essentially means that you'll either need the Lutron Smart Bridge or a smart hub that's capable of controlling the 434 MHz devices. That is, if you desire whole home integration. The Wink is just such a hub, so that's what we'll be using today. If you want or need to use the SmartThings with the Lutron devices, you'll need to do a little bit of research. SmartThings does not natively support ClearConnect. According to Samsung, there are currently no plans to support Lutron, but there may be some third-party apps that will allow you to connect. I won't be covering these in this video. If you're wanting to use the Lutron switch as a three-way switch, you can use the Pico remote by mounting it inside this Lutron Pico remote wall plate bracket. In this video, I'm going to walk you through how to install this smart switch in both the single switch application and the three-way switch application. So let's go get this thing installed. Okay, we're going to be working on this single switch right here that controls this one light bulb. This is just a standalone switch in a single gang box that controls the light. And the first thing we're going to do, as usual, is turn off power at the circuit breaker. I'm going to go ahead and get this all opened up. Now, it's always a good idea after you've shut off the breaker, just come back in and test for power real quick. Make sure you got the correct circuit breaker, and we'll go ahead and pull that out and get zoomed in on that so we can get a better look at what's going on. All right, so looking at the Lutron switch here, if we turn this around, what you're going to see is this does have a green ground wire and only two black wires. So we really only need to be able to connect into these two wires right here, one of which is coming in from the power and the other one's going off to control the light. And we will need to get back in the box and get the ground wires. Those are those bare copper wires that you see right there. And that's what we're going to need to get this installed. Okay, so one thing that I wanted to try just to see if it would work is I have not hooked up the ground wire. I'm going to turn power back on to make sure everything's nice and out of the way here. And we're turning power back on. Now, I'm not going to recommend that you run this without that ground wire hooked up. I just want to confirm that it would. If you don't have any of the copper grounding wires in that outlet box, it may be possible to do this. I don't know what it's going to do to the electronics inside this switch, but it does look like it's going to work. All right, turn that power back off. Then pushed back in the box, nice. Make sure we're on the right side up. And you're going to need the screws out of the little baggie there. Get that all centered in there. Just do your last bit of tightening. snaps right on. So now what we're going to do is we're going to just remove it back to here. I want to pull this back to a normal switch box, and we're going to install it over here. This is my three-way switch, and we're going to pull these three-way switches out, and we're going to put this one over here, and we're going to use that Pico remote, and we're going to put this into a three-way switch installation. Now, I've recently released a video that talks about three-way switch installation. If you're curious how that works, I'm not going to go over it again here, but there'll be a link to that video popping out, and it'll be in the description below. But what you should normally see in a three-way switch is you'll have your power coming in, and then normal three-way, you'll have a black wire and a red wire. These are the traveler switches. These come over to the other switch, and then you have a wire coming in, and then one wire goes out to the light. And again, I suggest you watch that other video because that'll clear it all up. Now we're going to walk through, because we're going to be using the remote, we'd have no more need for this traveler wire. So the first thing we're going to do is cap this off, and then the installation of that Lutron switch is going to be the exact same way. We're just going to hook these things right in, hook that ground wire up, put it in, and we're going to cap that off right there. So just going to throw a cap on that. That's just a safety precaution. And that traveler wire we can shove way back into the back of the box. It really doesn't matter with this switch anything about the line or the load. You can just hook these straight in. So we've got the power wires there. It's gone. And we can just put that in right there. All right. So we've got the red wire capped off, we've got the two black wires hooked up, we've got that ground wire hooked up, and we just make sure we have the right side up. Now these go in there a little bit tight, but you can see it will fit in there. So let's go ahead and get that in, and then we'll move over to the next box. Okay, so in the second box, the in wire and the out wire, we're just direct wiring those together. So this switch is actually what's controlling through this box out to the light bulb. So those two are already connected together through those WAGO wire nuts there. We'll push those back in. The ground wire is the same. We don't even need to worry about that ground wire. We're going to shove that back in there. And just for added protection, so it doesn't hit anything, we're just going to cap that wire off and put that in. The next step is to get that Pico bracket installed. When you look at the remote, on the back side of the remote, you'll see you've got some double back tape. Now, if you'd wanted to, you could actually just pull that off, stick this on a wall, and just take some regular little screws there, and you could actually mount that on the wall, and nobody would probably ever notice that that wasn't there. So remember, we did that single switch installation over here. If we wanted to, we could just throw one of these up on the wall, and voila, you've got a three-way switch with no wiring. In this case, we already had a three-way switch and we wanted to use this as a replacement. So what we're going to do is, on the back here, this sits on a little plate. You can see this little plate just pops right out, so we're not going to be using that double back tape. And then this is the bracket, and on this bracket down at the bottom, you'll see there's a little piece here. I don't know how well you can see it. This comes out just a little bit. See, I'm pushing it out there. Where we slid that double back tape out, you're just going to slide this into that same place and push it down in there real nice. And then that's going to pop in nicely like that. And watching our orientation on the switch there, on the little remote, we're just going to get that started in there. All right, we've got the switch in there. Now we should be able to turn our power back on. Nothing blows up. Turn that switch on, turn that switch off. All right. Now they actually sell these cover plates here. I didn't get one. We're just going to put that old plate right back on there. And okay, so we have the actual smart switch here, and then we have the Pico remote here, both mounted into wall boxes. The next thing we're going to do is mount this in. So what we'll do
is we'll hold on to the off button for about 6 seconds, and we should see these green lights right here flash. There we go. Now it's ready to pair, and we're going to hold on to this for 6 seconds. And we are paired. So if I push that, I'll turn my light off, turn my light on, turn my light off. All right, so last but not least, let's get this into the Wink Hub. In our Wink app, go to the Add Product on the Hub, just as we always do. All right, lights. And right up at the top, you see the Caseta in-wall dimmer. We're going after that. Go through the next. And connect now. And we just push down and hold that until it starts blinking. And there we go. Give that a couple seconds to register. And we have success. So we can also connect the remote. We'll do that. Next. Next. Same process. Hold down. 6 seconds. A little green light appears, starts flashing rapidly. And give it another couple seconds and we should hit that success screen. There we go. All right. As though it was the first time I ever did this. Okay, so let's try it out. On, off. We'll long press and hold this, check out the dim. All right. Bring that down. There we go. Off from the remote. He said off from the remote. All right, so what it looks like is I paired this with my Wink Hub and now it doesn't work. So I'm guessing I didn't want to do that. So let's go back and let's turn that off for fun. Three times, get it into pairing mode. Pair it back to that. All right. Off. On. All right, so what we just learned there is do not pair the remote with the Wink Hub. That'll override its pairing over to the master switch. So pair these two together like we did originally, and then pair it to the Wink Hub, and you should have on, off, and on functionality. And just for giggles, I want to look and see how long it takes for the Wink app to respond. So we turn that off, and pretty quick it updates back in the Wink app that the light's on or off. So on and off. There you go. Other than being painful, that was painless. All right, so there's the finished product in my bar. All the way on, all the way off, and we're controlling this light right up here. Okay, and because we have this hooked in through the Echo, Alexa, turn bar light on. I really like this switch. Since I have it connected into my Wink Hub, I have full control over the switch just like I do with every other smart device, which is pretty cool. I've also left a link to the full Pico remote configuration guide in the description below. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe and don't forget to click like. And over here, there are a couple of other videos that you might enjoy. For more reviews, tips, and DIY videos, visit azhb.com. And thanks to all of you that already follow me over on Facebook or Twitter. Both are at DIY Smart Home Guide. Until next time, cheers.